أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعص الله ورسوله فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على أزواجه وذريته وقال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أقوى المؤمنين إيمانا أحسنهم خلقا وخياركم خياركم لنسائهم أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Respected listeners, the worship we do does not bring beauty in our lives in the sense it does not become visible. Al-Islam, Bunya Islam al-Khams, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Islam, the foundation of Islam is based on five things. And the foundation of this beautiful center is not visible. You cannot see the beauty of the foundation. That is what I mean to say. But what you see is the beauty of the structure. You see the beautiful columns, you see the beautiful ceiling, you see the beautiful flooring, everything. That is visible. Similarly, the worship we do, because it is the foundation, the salah, the hajj, the zakah, the fasting, it is not visible. The beauty of it is not seen because it is hidden. What is seen? أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most perfect in regards to their faith amongst the believers are those whose character is good, whose akhlaq are good. And these akhlaq are visible. If your worship is weak, it can be hidden. But if our akhlaq are weak, they're visible. I'm becoming angry quickly, I'm intolerant, I'm impatient. All these things become visible in the eyes of people. That is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a person comes to you and says, O Prophet of Allah, what is the best iman a person can have? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you have good akhlaq and your iman will become complete, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I want to become the best of the human beings, O Prophet of Allah, a person comes to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Prophet of Allah, I want to be the best of the human beings. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't tell him, pray salah. Of course, obligatory salah is obligatory upon all of us. He didn't tell him to pray extra optional salah. He didn't tell him to recite extra Quran or do hajjis after hajjis or umrahs after umrahs. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you do the khidmah of the people. You serve the people and you will become the best among the human beings. That is why Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Islam, al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimu min lisanihi wa yadihi. Aw kama qala. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a Muslim, Ayyul imani ayyul islami afdal ya Rasulullah? Which Islam is the best, O Prophet of Allah? A sahabi comes and asks Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Islam is the best? Again, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not tell him salah, zakat, hajj, Quran recitation, dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which Islam is the best, O Prophet of Allah? Al-Muslim, man salim al-Muslimuna bilisanihi wa yadihi. That person's Islam is best from whose tongue
from whose tongue other Muslims, from his tongue and his hands, other Muslims are saved. And the scholars say Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this saying in Madinah al-Munawwara when only Muslims were living over there. What it implies is Muslims or non-Muslims, because non-Muslims are our human brothers. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam implied both. A Muslim is the one from whose tongue Muslims and his or her non-Muslim brothers are saved from his or her tongue and their hand. And then it came to which Iman is the best, O Prophet of Allah. How does Iman get complete? The faith gets complete, O Prophet of Allah. Prophet said, you complete your akhlaq, you have good akhlaq, you have good character, your Iman will be complete, said Prophet. Akhlaq brings beauty to our life, respected listeners. Wealth, status, position, the beauty of the house with chandeliers and mansions do not bring beauty to our homes like would akhlaq bring the beauty to our homes. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a man cannot suffice, a human being cannot suffice other human beings with his or her wealth. You will not be able to suffice, satisfy all the human beings or any amount of human beings you want to, but you can suffice them with good akhlaq and good character. Good akhlaq, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, good akhlaq melt your sins like the sun melts the ice. Like the sun melts the ice. That is how good akhlaq. That is why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person who has good akhlaq, who has good manners, good conduct, good behavior, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah azza wa jal will give him that position, darajat al-sa'im al-qa'im. Allah will give him or her that position as the one who prays all night long from the time they mature till they die, and they fasted all their life from the time they mature till they die. Who can do that? It's humanly impossible. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is willing to give that status, those rewards, these rewards which cannot be accomplished by immense amount, abundant amount of worship. But Allah is giving it with good akhlaq and good characters. مَا مِن شَيْءٍ أَثْقَلُ فِي مِيزَانِ الْمُؤْمِنِ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, nothing weighs heavier on the scales on the day of judgment. Nothing weighs heavier on the scales of judgment, on the day of judgment, on your scales, than your good akhlaq and good character. Nothing weighs heavier. Why? Because something that is scarce, something that is rare, the price goes up. The price goes up. Extremely hard to find people. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Sahaba heard these virtues of good akhlaq from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and what the Quran talks, the Sahaba Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "Ya Rasulullah, man husnul akhlaq? What are good akhlaq, O Prophet of Allah?" Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Three things: Sil man khata'ak, wa'fu amman dhalamak." Join ties with those who break away from you, do good to those who do bad to you, and forgive those who are unjust to you. Join ties with those who break away from you, do good to those who do bad to you, and forgive those who are unjust to you. Easier said than if these come into my life will become paradise on this earth. If these come into your life will become paradise on this earth. Our children, our parents, our spouses. Ummi Habiba radiallahu anha, mother of the believers, wife of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. She was married and her husband died. She was a widow. After some time, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam proposed her and married her. And after some time, she asks, in the later days of the life of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, O Prophet of Allah, if a woman marries, her husband dies, Allah will make him enter paradise. And she marries another man after that, he dies, Allah will make him enter paradise. She dies, Allah will make her enter paradise. Whose husband will she be in paradise if Allah makes him enter paradise, O Prophet? Prophet ﷺ said, she will be the wife of that husband whose akhlaq were good in this world. O Umme Habiba, good akhlaq bring nothing but khair and good. Good akhlaq bring nothing but khair and good, said Prophet ﷺ. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who served Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam for 10 years in Madinatul Munawwarah, he says, a man with good akhlaq, it can take him or her to the highest abode in paradise, Jannatul Firdaws, even though he may be a person of not abundant worship. He may not be a person of much worship at all, but his or her good akhlaq will take him or her to Jannatul Firdaws. And he said, a person with bad akhlaq, a person with bad akhlaq and character, even though he may be a person of abundant worship, can put him into the lowest pit of the fire. Junayd al-Baghdadi rahmatullahi says, four things take a person to the highest abode in paradise. Forbearance, meaning tolerance in the face of provocation, and patience in the face of provocation. Not an easy thing. Somebody comes and curses us, yells and says anything, slanders us, curses us, abuses us verbally. You tell them, brother, just say salam to him, say how is he doing. The next day, you say, I can't do that. Don't want to see his face, I don't want to talk to him. But you tell the same person, can you pray tahajjud all night? It's not a problem. I can fast, I can pray tahajjud all night, I can read Quran, but I cannot talk to that person. Akhlaq, respect and respect. Patience in the face of provocation. Tolerance and patience in the face of provocation. Ibrahim bin Adam rahmatullah alayhi, one of the great pious princes, was he was heir to the throne of Afghanistan. He left everything in search and recognition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's walking, and a soldier comes on a horse and he says, are you a slave? He says, yes. He says, very inhabited place, country. He says, I live over there. And he points to the cemetery. And the soldier says, don't joke with me. I'm asking you, where do you live? He says, I live right there in the cemetery. Then the soldier becomes really angry and he hits him with the base of his sword really hard on his head. Ibrahim bin Adam rahmatullahi falls down unconscious. The soldier picks him up, puts him on his horse, brings him to the town. The people surround him, Ibrahim bin Adam, what happened to him? The soldier says, this is Ibrahim bin Adam? What did they do to him? He kisses his feet, kisses him, by the time he has gained consciousness, he says, please forgive me. Ibrahim bin Adam says, The moment you hit me with your space of the sword on my head, I said, oh Allah, make him enter paradise. The people said, but he did injustice to you. He called you a slave and hit you. He did injustice to you. He says, yes, he called me a slave. He didn't ask me whose slave I was. I'm a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the reason I made the dua for him is because I didn't want any good to come from his evil to me. I didn't want the khair good from Allah to come from his evil to me. I wanted the good to come from my patience and forbearance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Malik bin Dinar rahmatullah is walking on the streets of Baghdad. The woman comes and says, you're a hypocrite. And he smiles and says, nobody recognized me as well as you did. Ad-Darani rahmatullah alayhi. A man comes and slanders and abuses him, scolds him verbally, everything, left and right. And he says, if my virtues are less on the scales of judgment, I'm worse than what you're saying. But if my virtues are heavier, then what you're saying is not going to harm me. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. A man comes and says, same kind of stuff to Abu Bakr radiallahu. He says, what Allah has hidden of my faults from you are worse than what you're telling me. Are more heinous than what you're telling me and accusing me of. Shibir rahmatullah is walking. A person comes and says to him this, that, this. He says, if what you're saying is true, may Allah forgive me. And if what you're saying is lies, may Allah forgive you. How did these people reach this state respected listeners? A state of equilibrium, not just outside, but inside. Their hearts were clean of any hatred, malice, rancor, arrogance. اللهم اجعلني في عيني صغيرة وفي أعين الناس كبيرة أو كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make the dua, oh Allah, make me small in the eyes of the people and make me big in your eyes, oh Allah Respected listeners, we are weak in worship, we are weak in recitation of the Quran, in doing dhikr and your optional salats. But let us make this resolution today that I'm going to make my house a paradise. One sweet word, respected listeners, one sweet word in our homes, to our children, to our spouses, and save generations to come. One bitter word from this tongue can destroy generations. That is how serious and significant and important the depth of the words that come from our tongue. One bitter word can poison the ocean. That is how poisonous it can be. One sweet word, oceans filled with honey cannot compete with the sweetness that comes. Words can be magic. That is why shaitan, subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what time is it? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, shaitan has his own court, his throne is on the waters of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Other shayateen come and report to him, of the fitna they have spread on the earth. One comes and says, I made this person miss salah. Another one comes and says, I made this person stop going to the masjid. And he says, good, good, good. I made him lie, I made him cheat. Good, good, good. One shaitan comes and says, today I went to a home. There was a husband and wife living, there was a lot of love between them. But I created fitna between them. I made them argue with each other. I made them fight with each other. I made them separate. This shaitan jumps up from his throne and he says, bravo, excellent, what a great job you have done. Like he said, you are the man. He must say, you are the shaitan. Why? Because when a person drinks, it's against his own thing. He's committing his sin, it's between him and Allah. Even if a person is committing adultery, fornication, it's between him and Allah. That is why Prophet ﷺ said, Al-ghibatu ashaddu min az-zina. Backbiting is worse than committing adultery and fornication. Why? Because it's between you violating the rights of fellow human being, for which the court of Allah is tough. Allah will not forgive us until the other people forgive us. But when a person has broken a family, split apart a husband and a wife, the shaitan has not only split apart a husband and wife, that family, those kids in the family, the generation that is affected. And that is where shaitan comes and he becomes so happy. Let us bring these akhlaq into our lives. سِلْمَ الْخَطَأَ وَعْفُ أَمَّنْ تَلَمَ وَأَحْسِنُ إِلَى مَنْ أَسَاءَ لِي. Join ties with those who break away from you. Do good to those who do bad to you. Forgive those who are unjust to us. Then we will see how our life becomes. Allah will give us the sweetness of iman. Allah will give us the sweetness of living our lives. The sweetness that will come in our relationships with our children, with our spouses, our neighbors, our communities. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even though Allah praises him in the Quran, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. O Prophet of Allah, you are of a tremendous character. People saw the miracles. People saw him splitting the moon. But they did not accept Islam. They saw angels. The mushrikeen saw the angels in the Battle of Badr. They did not accept Islam. They heard the most beautiful recitation of the Quran. They did not accept Islam. But they saw 10,000 soldiers marching into Makkah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fully armed, did not accept Islam. But when they saw the akhlaq of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they saw his akhlaq, they came in tens and thousands and droves to Islam. May Allah purify our lives with good akhlaq. Rabbana adina fi dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adhaban nar. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahmah innaka antal wahhab. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي.